Graceland was a Paul Simon record that kind of rocked a little harder than some of the ones just before that. The ones just before, of course, had great songs on, but this one kind of had a little bit more low-end going on.
I really think that the next generation still kind of has a pretty deep connection to Graceland. It was really evocative of being on like road trips with their family when they were, you know, 5 or 6 years old.
These are the days of miracle and wonder. This is the long distance call. The way the camera follows us in slow-mo.
It was just, it just sort of opened up a space inside of you.
Look to a distant constellation that's dying in a corner of the sky. These are the days of miracle and wonder. And don't cry, baby, don't cry, don't cry.
The music that led me to South Africa was accordion jive hits by the Boyoyo Boys. I used to play this tape all the time, and I asked the record company, do we have anybody, you know, in South Africa? They said, yeah.
Producer Hilton Rosenthal,
Paul, put the cassette in, played this thing, and he sang. And I said to him, you know, you can just do that here in New York. Just get a couple of great players, and, you know. You've got the instrumentation, the players certainly do that. And he looked at me and he said, no, I'm going down there.
I saw this guy with
just hanging
with cowboy boots, you know? And I was kind of asking myself, what is this guy trying to do? Because he's trying to, you know, fuse pop music plus, you know, African music.
For me,
music is the closest thing to religion. And if it's utilized in the right way, it can inform and bring people closer, and they can find solutions to their problems. And Graceland did that.
I don't want no part of your life. I don't want no part of this crazy love. I don't want no part of your love.
So we try I Know What I Know?
Yeah.
I was in South Africa for a very short time, like maybe 10 or 12 days, recording frantically. And it was exhilarating. It was really amazing. When I recorded with General Shirinda, the song that became I Know What I Know.
They came in with the whole family, mothers and children. It was like a party.
I asked him, what's that song about? And he said, you know, it's about, remember those 60s when, you know, when girls wore really short skirts, wasn't that great? That's what it was about. They're making up pop music.
One day, Ray started playing the riff. Next morning, I said to him, I have a feeling that yesterday, at least one of the hits from this album was recorded.
It really was world music in that people were trading information that they knew. He knew what I had done, and he was giving it to me with the information that he also knew from being a South African guitarist with roots in Mali.
If you be my bodyguard, I can be your long lost pal. I can call you Betty, and Betty, when you call me, you can call me out.
I will try to make you leg on child.
They were doing the song, Diamonds on the Soles of His Shoes.
We decided to put Ladysmith Black Mambazo at the end of the track. And they had never sung with musicians before. They're always sang a cappella.
We were there maybe not even 2 hours' time. And then Paul Simon said, right at the end, just do this. Ta-na-na-na, 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 ta-na-na-na. Oh, yeah. Everybody was having a good time. Ta-na-na-na, ta-na-na-na.
The challenge on this album was there were no songs, there was no arrangement. So we finished all our editing, we made tracks that had some semblance of a song there, and he went out and tried desperately to put words to each one.
So you get a song like Graceland, where, you know, in the middle of the song, it's there's a girl in New York City who calls herself the Human Trampoline.
There's a girl in New York City who calls herself the Human Trampoline.
A lyric that would never appear in a South African song. I mean, it was a very New York lyric. I was taking absurdist lyrics, which I thought had no place with this rhythm track, and finally saying, well, maybe it does have a place.
Well, everybody sees your glow.
And I kept singing this chorus, I'm going to Graceland, I'm going to Graceland, and I kept thinking, well, of course, that'll go away because the song is not about Elvis Presley or Graceland. I mean, it's a South African record, but it wouldn't go away. And finally, I said, it's not going away, I better go to Graceland. You know, that gave the song a larger meaning. And in fact, it gave the album a larger meaning, and that's why I use that as the title for the whole album.
We all will be received in Graceland.
For me, Graceland is a learning experience of a uniquely elevated level in my life, musically, politically, everything about growing up. It's the gift that I got.